the internal line tool to trace patterns in CLO. By now I've already imported photos of my patterns and I've made sure they are the right size by checking my ruler. So now I'm going to go ahead and trace the patterns using the internal line tool. All these patterns are placed on a piece of fabric, so that's why I'm using the internal line tool. I don't really need my 3D window, so I'm going to go ahead and click the bottom corner button to show just 2D. I'm going to pan up, kind of zoom in, and I'll start with the one in the top corner. I like to hit the letter G. That takes us to the internal line drawing tool. And I'm going to go ahead and click. I'm going to click. I'm going to click because this is straight. Here we have a curve, so I'm going to click and drag. And I can always go back and clean up these little handlebars if it's funky. I don't want the handlebar over here because it's going to create a curve and I don't want a curve. So if I click this point one time, that handlebar goes away. And then I'm tracing the largest size. Again, I don't need that new handlebar because it's going to draw a curve line and I don't want that. So I'll click one time on that anchor point. Looks like this line is slightly curved, so I'll come in the middle, do a click and drag, and this time I do want the handlebar. I do want it to be curved. Click. I'll do a click and drag. As I'm tracing, I'm realizing probably would have been a good idea to iron these pattern pieces so they're a little smoother, but that's okay. We'll do some fittings and CLO once it's drafted. Okay, there's the pattern piece. Now what I should do next is go ahead and trace my internal lines that I'll want also for placement. So I'm doing size small, so I will click here, come straight down, do a click and drag, another click and drag. So I'm clicking the button on my mouse, left button, and I'm sliding my mouse. That's what I call click and drag. And click, I'm done, I'm gonna hit enter. I'll go ahead and click this line, click one time to the first S, and click for the second S. Oops, it looks like I did not do a good job. I'm gonna enter, tracing this pocket, I just noticed. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit the letter A, and I'm gonna select this internal line. I'm gonna delete it and just do it again. It looks like I traced the small and the extra small on accident. I'm gonna click the letter G, so I'm back in my internal line tool. I'm going to click one time. Now I'm going to do my click and drag. Click, and then I'll come up on this line instead. Click and drag, and click. Okay, I'm going to hit enter. I'm going to go ahead and trace this dotted line as well for our fly. Click and drag. I don't want this handlebar, so I'm going to click the anchor point, come straight up, and hit enter because I am done. Okay, crotch line, I'm gonna doing size small, so I'll click once, click to finish, hit enter. Okay, we have a flap line, okay, I'll click the small, click enter. Okay, let's see what else. Maybe I should do the notches, I don't think I need them. So I might not do it. Looks like there's another placement line. I guess I'll just click it for now. Maybe I'll also click here. Click, click, return. Okay, so now let's go ahead and trace this guy. So I'm gonna get our tracing tool. That's our outline tool or seam allowance tool, so not that one. Looks like a pocket. Oh, there it is. That's our trace tool. Okay, and I can go ahead and hold shift and click the outline of the pattern and all the internal lines should also come along with it. We will see. This will be a good test. So I'm just clicking the outline. There we are. I'll right click. Now my mouse is hovering over this. It's not hovering over here. It's hovering over what's selected. And I'll say trace as a pattern because right now it's internal shape. Click. Voila. Now it's white, has yellow outline, not red lines. So it is now a pattern, which is great. So I should probably go ahead and name it. Let's see what this is called. Oh, it's called front. So I'm gonna name it front as well. That was in my property editor. And that's it.